Buongiorno guys! Today we are going to Milan and now we're heading to Villa Costanza to take the Flixbus. To go from Florence to Milan, the best choice is to take a bus. If you want a cheaper fare, the distance between Florence and Milan is 308 kilometers, which takes us a minimum of 3 hours and 25 minutes. The travel is kinda long, so make sure you have food and water with you. Now guys, we arrive here in Milan and now we're heading to our hotel to freshen up and starting our day with a tour in National Science and Technology Leonardo da Vinci Museum, which is just 15 to 20 minutes far from our hotel. Museo Nazionale Scienza e Tecnologia Leonardo da Vinci in Milan is dedicated to painter and scientist Leonardo da Vinci. It's the largest science and technology museum in Italy. It was opened on 5 February 1953 and inaugurated by Prime Minister Alcide De Gasperi. Day 2, going to St. Moritz. So now guys, we are going to the station of Milan to take our train, Trenitalia, going to Tirano. And from Tirano, we're going to wait our Bernina Express Panorama going to Switzerland. The train journey time but between Milan and Tirano is around 2 hours and 32 minutes. And from Tirano, we will wait our Bernina Express Panorama. Tirano is an Italian town of 8,792 inhabitants in the province of Sondrio in Lombardy. A few minutes from the border with Switzerland, it is made famous for its sanctuary dedicated to the Madonna of Tirano and for being the terminus of the fixture square Tirano-St. Moritz railway line. Surely Tirano is famous for being the starting point of the Bernina train, the wonderful panoramic railway convoy that connects Lombardy and Switzerland, at the Tirano station to take the little red train.
Bernina Express! Ayan, so nice. Taas ng ano.
The Bernina Red Train travels the Tirano-St. Moritz section in less than 3 hours. A fascinating route that winds through dream landscapes, frozen lakes, snow cape, mountains, and unspoiled places. Precisely for this and many other reasons, the section traveled by the Bernina Red Train has been part of the UNESCO World Heritage since 2008. It is the only Swiss railway that crossed the Alps. Thank you. Your journey for an entire route all in one go will last approximately 2 hours and 30 minutes with regional trains. It will take you about 2 hours and 15 minutes if on the other hand, you'll travel aboard the Bernina Express, the slowest express in Europe and one of the most famous panoramic trains of the Swiss railways.
Cold. St. Moritz. Woohoo. Ah, Switzerland. Restaurant. Wow. This is a restaurant. A nice view of St. Moritz. So guys, this is a frozen lake. Yan, frozen yan siya na lake. Kaya puro na yan ice oil. Oh.
How much it costs the ticket. The ticket has different costs. The classic ticket for the day use, Terranu St. Moritz return, costs 64 Swiss francs. Capital passion and design. It's a metropolis in northern Italy and it is the capital of Lombardy. Headquarters of an Italian stock exchange, it is a financial hub also famous for its restaurants and exclusive shops. The Gothic style cathedral and the convent of Santa Maria della Grazie, which houses the fresco The Last Supper by Leonardo da Vinci, bear witness the artistic and cultural heritage of the city. The Castello Sforzesco is a large fortified complex located in Milan, just outside the historic center of the city. It was built in the 15th century by Francesco Sforza, who had recently become Duke of Milan. On the remains of a previous 14th century medieval fortification known as Castello di Porta Giovia. The castle is quite large. Also equipped with a beautiful courtyard with free access. Inside, there are various exhibitions, including the Castle Museum. With 5 euros, you can see the historic area and furniture exhibition, the art gallery, and the exhibition of musical instruments. It's quite big, so you need at least a couple of hours to go around everything well. There are numerous paintings and sculptures, but also more particular things like the room dedicated to weapons. I recommend you to visit this place. Sightseeing bus, more than 40 stops, 4 lines, 7 buses, and commentary in 10 languages allow you to discover and visit the Castello Sforzesco, Santa Maria della Grazie, Piazza Cordosio, thanks to the historic line, and then continue towards the Duomo, pass under the Bernina, and reach the La Scala Theater. The Duomo of Milan is considered the third largest Catholic church in the world. Look at the fantastic photos, discover the history and curiosities about Duomo of Milan. That's all the video for today. Thank you so much guys for watching my vlog, and I hope you like and subscribe this channel. See you soon. Ciao.